such a long time that when you revolve off, that you can revolve off as chairman rather than as a member.
I don't think it makes any difference.
I'm just saying that I'm trying to honor your service.
Well, I appreciate that.
And then we can have another election, which makes sense to me, after you revolve off. And the new person that comes in, whoever that may be, will be able to vote. And he'll be serving under whoever is chairman, so it will make sense to, have you just.
Well, I guess we need to see if there's any other nominations. Are there any other nominations?
Go ahead, second, I guess.
Okay. Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor? All decline? So motion dies. So now what do we do?
Well, it's interesting. The board commissioner's rules provide that in the case of a tie, a substantive vote is an automatic default. This board has not adopted Robert's rules, has it?
No.
Does the plan commission, the UDC, doesn't mention Robert's rules, does it?
It's not.
No.
The typical rule under Roberts is that a tie vote means that you do not secure a majority. That's the typical rule, which means the matter would fail. So, in that situation, since the, I need to make sure, has the planning commission ever resorted, though, to using the VOC rules as a matter of just consistency with the board of commissioners? See, I seem to, if they haven't, sure.
We've never had it.
Discussed them at times, but never seen a formal.
Do the bylaws addresses and all?
No, we tried to read the bylaws a couple years ago, and it was a total failure. So we have very little in the way of bylaws.
There's nothing in there as far as Robert, or which rules take precedence and procedure. Rules and procedures talk about the call meeting, the order in which you call the meeting.
Thank you for the indulgence. So let's take a look for a vote.
Did we try to jump in? Yes, I want to jump in on that, but you know, we have a second. I'm trying to get past. So we're stuck now with literally nothing.
Well, can we go on with other nominations?
Well, I guess we're trying to resolve this. Maybe that you did, maybe nothing elected.
Whatever. It's just presiding over the meeting.
Okay, here it is, the voting. In the event of a tie, the substitute motion, the motion shall be deemed automatically postponed until the next meeting when the tie is approved. That's your bylaws, so that does stand. So that the issue of chairman has been postponed until the next meeting. I think the work session will be seen.
Why don't they postpone it for one?
And at the end of the meeting.
What?
Yeah.
Could we not postpone it until our deal arrives?
And you know what? You see what it says? Well, it says ask should be deemed automatically postponed until the next meeting when the tie can be broken.
But we'll do the next meeting.
Except for Alan Neal's to be here at 7.
Yeah, I think it needs to be postponed.
Until?
Until the next work session.
Work session, yeah. Not the public hearing.
Right. The next live meeting. That's fine.
Okay.
So?
That's fine.
Well, that's it. You can continue. That's fine.
All right. Next, would anyone like to make a motion for secretary?
I would like to nominate Craig Nolen, please.
I'd like
to have a little discussion. Not that I'm not favored Craig, but we do have our rule of bylaws do state that we don't have to have a secretary, and the clown can fill in that position. And it's my understanding that this is not anything against him, but I think we should just do away with the position of secretary and just have a chairman. We did that last time around and did away with the
vice
chairman. And if we can do away with the vice chairman, good sense that we do it away with the secretary, because most of, well, almost all of the secretary's work is done by the...
I thought it said we had to have a secretary.
No.
We have to have someone to...
The UDC says the planning commission may appoint a secretary, or in lieu of that appointment, the director of planning and community development shall serve as secretary.
And so that's what I'm suggesting.
But Tom would preside over meetings if the chair was not...
No, that could not work.
Okay. Okay, so then what would happen in lieu of that? That's what the secretary...
What we could do, we can elect officers at any meeting. And if we didn't have somebody there, we could elect somebody as a chairman for the one meeting. And because our bylaws say that we're to elect a chairman at least every 2 years. And when we discussed that, we discussed that, you know, you can elect a chairman for every meeting. For every meeting, you could have a different chairman. So I just think that it would cut down on a lot of work and stuff. And besides, Tom is the one who knows the stuff inside out. And personally, I would like to see him be the secretary.
Okay, can we go ahead with our vote? We have a motion, we have a second. That Craig be the secretary. All in favor? Motion carries.